Good day to you. I'm Pastora Rose and welcome once again to Jesus Our Healer. Today, we want to encourage you that whatever sickness you have, God is the one who can heal you. We want to encourage you that even as we read some of the promises of God in the Bible, let it sink deep into your hearts and let it grow and develop the faith for your complete healing. In Philippians chapter 4, verse 6, it says here, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God." In Psalm 103, verse 1 to 3, "Praise the Lord, O my soul, all my inmost being, praise His holy name. Praise the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits, who forgives all your sins and heals all your diseases." Exodus 15:26. "If you diligently listen to the voice of the Lord your God and do with that which is right in His eyes and give ear to His commandments and keep all His statutes, I will put none of the diseases on you that I put on the Egyptians, for I am the Lord your healer." Beloved brothers and sisters, today we want to encourage you that God is your healer. So we don't need to respond in fear or in worry, because God is faithful and true to His promises. And when He said that by His wounds you are healed, you are healed in Jesus' name. Right now, if you are sick in your body, I want you to lay your hands on the part of your body that is sick, and we want to pray for you. Also, if you are here and you cannot sleep because of too much worry or fear, we want to ask God for that fear to be driven off in your hearts, and instead, God to put peace in your heart today. Let's pray. Father, we want to thank you so much, O God, because we believe, Lord, that by your wounds, O God, your people are healed in Jesus' name. We command, O God, every sickness, every disease, O God, to leave the bodies of your people. God, we believe, O God, that you are our powerful God, that with you, Lord, nothing is impossible. And so, Father, we pray, O God, as we lift up to you your people, even as they lay their hand on the part of their body that is sick, we ask, O God, in Jesus' name, for healing to flow from the top of their head to the very sole of their feet, O God. And Lord, some of them are worried because of their sickness, O God, to the point that they cannot even sleep at night. We ask in Jesus' name, just like what you have promised, O God, that you grant sleep to your beloved. We pray, Lord, that you're gonna cause them, O God, to respond in faith, O God, and let go of the fear, O God. Let the fear be driven off in their hearts, O God. And instead, O God, we pray that the peace of God that transcends all understanding will be in their hearts, O God. Your peace, O God, will be their umpire, O God. Lord, even today, O God, we pray that you're gonna cause them to be reminded of the wonderful promises that you have for them, that you're gonna cause them, O God, cause the word of God to really sink deep into their hearts, O God, and believe that by your wounds, O God, they will be healed. And believe, O God, that you are the God who restores. And believe, O God, that it will end well for them. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. At this time, I want to encourage you to open up your hearts as we sing this beautiful song that Sister Bev herself composed, "You Are My Peace and You Are My Healer." This is to encourage you that there is no reason for you to be afraid, because God is your protector and He will heal you.
To you. Oh,
Amen and amen. Thank you so much for joining us today in prayer. We believe that even at this moment, God is touching you and healing you completely. Join us once again tomorrow, 7:30 a.m. God bless you and have a great day.
Jesus, our healer.